Hey everyone, happy Thanksgiving pre-eve. We still got about, I want to say 2 days before crunch time really starts. Now, I am going to be making a sweet potato pie, but I'm going to be doing two different ways. I'm doing one, I just found a recipe literally not even an hour ago of sweet potato bites, which I'm going to be doing. You need a muffin pan to do those. And then the other one, I'm just gonna do the traditional sweet potato pie. And so my potatoes were roasted for about, I wanna say, an hour and some change at 400 in the oven. I let them cool, and now I'm just letting the butter kinda melt over these. Now, unfortunately, you guys, I don't have my potato masher. MIA. So, I gotta use a spoon here or something that's kinda not gonna just bend up like my whisk. So, I gotta do it that way. And I'm just gonna mash these up. I totally forgot about my potato masher. I'm going to be doing Trisha Yearwood's recipe. We really enjoy her show on Food Network. Her style of cooking, is kind of like, I want to say, I forget where she's from, but I don't want that camera to fall. I cleared off most of this table just to get room in here. I think she's from the country, but I forgot, like, where and all that. I think probably Tennessee, I don't know. But she has a cooking show on the Food Network, and she cooks really good. Her recipes are, like, kind of, like, you know, really flavorful and really kind of like how, I guess, I just, how we kind of like our food tasting. Another one I like is Barefoot Contessa. She makes really good, her gravy, I do her gravy every year. It's, you just, you know, I was looking at the onions at Aldi and I was wondering why I usually get a bag of onions every year. You need onions, you need, drippings. You know why? Because I'm not doing the turkey. That's why I'm like, my mind's not even looking at that kind of stuff. You need the drippings, you need onions, you need, cream. The cream's optional. It's like the best gravy, you guys. It's really rich and creamy. Barefoot Contessa, look it up. It's really good. Like, that's the gravy I make every year, and I just, you know. But I'm trying to think, I was looking at the onions for a minute, and I was thinking, there's a reason why I need those. And it didn't come to me until just right now. But yeah, her and... there's quite a few. I'm going to watch the Food Network later just to kind of like, I don't know, get into the spirit, I guess. I love watching that and just getting ideas and stuff. Okay, so here it is. Now, unfortunately, I do not have a mixer yet. I didn't get my mixer yet. I'm fine with that because I only was going to need it for this recipe. And I can whisk it. I'm just making sure that everything's mashed really well before I, you know, get down to business. But I am going to have to get a potato masher at some point before Christmas because if you're going to be doing things with the actual potatoes, yeah, you need that. Okay, so Trisha's recipe, you guys, is really simple. You just preheat the oven to 305. All you're gonna need is, let me get my ingredients. You're going to need 2 or 3 roasted potatoes or a can of, sweet potatoes. You're gonna need some measuring spoons. You're going to need sugar. Let me put the sugar over here. Okay, you're going to need... this is what you need. Unfortunately, my dad's printer's not working, so I had to write everything out. 3/4 of sugar. So you need 3/4 cup of sugar, 2 large eggs, 4 tablespoons of butter. That's already been done, the butter part. 2 to 3 roasted potatoes, 1/4 cup of milk, 1/4 teaspoon of cinnamon, 1/4 teaspoon of nutmeg, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 1 pinch of salt, and 1 pie shell. So when you do these little bites, which is a totally different woman's recipe, but the recipe for the sweet potato pie kind of remains the same. It's the same thing. So here's my sweet potatoes. These ones aren't done yet. I'm gonna use these most likely for the casserole. I got about 3 left, and then I have those frozen ones from Trader Joe's. I don't know where that other potato went. There's a missing sweet potato somewhere over here. But anyway, this was the bag from Aldi, $1.79. Guys, go get some. Okay, so I'm just gonna mash these up a little longer, and then these smell like super buttery. I think I put a little bit more butter than she said, because I wanted to use up the rest of this one stick, and before I open up another one. Okay, look at that. Look at all that. Okay, 3/4 cup of sugar. Let me get the measuring cup. As much as I try to do everything by eye, there's some things, unless I'm like comfortable cooking them, I just do, you know, I follow the directions. Dude, I don't know where that other sweet potato went, but I need to find it before it gets bad. It disappears and gets bad somewhere. Here's my regular potatoes. Okay. Okay, so you need 3/4 cup of sugar. Now, the reason I don't typically get the flour and the sugars, because I only use it like this time of year, really. So they mostly get tossed out after that. That's why I didn't want to get flour, because I won't use it after the holidays. Okay, so 3/4 cup of sugar. But the sugar is okay because it, you know, during the holidays, you do kind of use it. Two eggs. Okay, let me mix this in first. Woo! This is like a mountain of snow up in here. Let me just get this all. Looks like I didn't even put anything. 2 eggs. 2 eggs. Mix those around. Oh my God, what was that with it? Fill in there. Oh, I thought something to fill in there was just the sugar in a little small little mound. Okay. So stir up your eggs and your sugar up in here. Four tablespoons of butter, 2 to 3 roasted potatoes, 1/4 cup of milk. Oh, that's where I forgot to go to the first reader. 1/4 cup of milk. Be right back, you guys. Break the milk. Real gentle with this so it doesn't make a mess. Some freaking spammer. Quarter teaspoon of cinnamon. Okay, so like I said, I don't have cinnamon or nutmeg. I think I do have cinnamon somewhere, but I don't know where it's at. I'm just going to use the pumpkin spice for like everything for this recipe. So quarter teaspoon of cinnamon and a quarter teaspoon of nutmeg. So just 2 teaspoons of everything. But of course, you guys, I'm going to taste this after. So before I put it in the shell. So I'm going to see what it needs more of later. 1 teaspoon of sugar. No. 1 teaspoon of vanilla. 1 teaspoon of vanilla. So, all over the place. Pinch of salt. And now, I'm going to mix all this up to some whipped goodness. Now this is where obviously a hand mixer comes in handy. Make it real smooth. Let me see if it tastes right first before I even keep going. Sometimes you don't taste like the nutmeg and cinnamon enough. Like you'll just taste the sweet potato. Like I've had somebody's and it was just like sweet potato. That's why I just like, you know what guys, that's why I just follow the directions with these, because I'm not like a baker like that, so I don't know. I mean, yeah, you're gonna taste how it's tasting before you put it in the pie shell and all that, but it's like, I just figured, whoa, it looks like baby food. Okay. So now, I'm gonna see if it's like, okay. Ay, ay, ay. Paper towels. Okay. Now, you guys, I'm gonna get the pie shells ready. Just so this video doesn't go too long. It's already kind of going too long. Let me put this to the side. Look at that, you guys. Woo! That feeling. You know what? Let me move some of this stuff out the way so I have some room on this table. I don't know why I got the cutting board out. They ended up not using it. All right. Got me some room. So, here's what I'm going to be doing. Here's the, for the mini ones I'm going to be making. So, I need like a little ice cream scoop. Just to scoop them out. Scoop them into the thing. All right. So, don't worry guys, I'm just going to show one or two, and then I'll show the finished product after. I just want to get it started. Okay, I don't know if I even need both shells. We'll see. Supposedly they have some mini pie crust. And that you use instead of this. But obviously I didn't know about this recipe until about now. So, okay, before I do it, let me spray. Let's see how many it fills. Okay, so you take your pie crust that's been sitting out for, I want to say, over an hour. If you do it before that, it's hard to really work with it. And then you just put them in the muffin tin like this. And then you just do that with as many as you have, and like as much as you have pie crust for. I'm trying to make them kind of a little even so that they're easy to take out of the thing when they're done. So I'm trying to. Doesn't really matter how the pie crust looks in these cups. What matters, in my opinion, is that you're able to get them out easily. And then, I wouldn't worry that much about them looking like cupcakes, really. I would just make sure that you at least have the bottom part good. Some of these are going to be a little thick, so I'm going to push these down a little more. Just so that the bottom is like, basically that you have the bottom crust. Like some of these are gonna have more crust than others. Okay. Now, I'm going to scoop the filling into each one. I didn't do the full dozen. I just did 9 of them right now, just to kind of demonstrate. Whoa, whoa, whoa. All right, and I'll do the rest, like, after. I just want to show this part. So, look, you guys, this is how mine look. They look like little empanada-looking things. So, just clean them up a little bit. So, yeah, you guys, I'm going to put these in the oven. And at 300, I'll put in the comment, like, how the actual statistics and everything on how long to bake them and what you need and everything. And then I'll show what they look like when they're done. But this is how they are, you guys. My little pecan. Not pecan. What am I thinking? That's my next goal. Maybe I'll do that at Christmas. I like pecan pie. But I don't know if I want to make it. But I'll buy it. Okay, so I have 8 of them right here. I'm going to put 4 more. And then I will show the finished result when they're done and cooled off and everything. All right, you guys. Talk to you guys soon. Happy pre-Thanksgiving. Bye.